Alright, so now that's over with, you can spawn the deuce to get right out of here and find the nearest motor forge. There, we're gonna buy some stuff. We've got an established shopping list that, you know, you can improvise and change things around once you're comfortable with the game, but as a starting runner, I would definitely recommend you just stick to the list that we have here, because I have my own kind of variation of the list that works for me, but at least this particular shopping trip is exactly the same, even on my like variation. So yeah, I would definitely recommend you stick with this. So you spam enter, get rid of this thing with escape, buy the nitrous canister, engine upgrade, machine gun, disgorger, and the X treatment razor's edge. And that will land you at zero fire tributes. You've spent everything you have. And those are some pretty good upgrades, you know, make the car quite a bit faster, make your axe a bit stronger, make the car, you know, a bit more offensively capable. So, all of those things just kind of, you know, make things easier, but the machine gun is absolutely mandatory. It's mandatory for the next mission, the Tour of Destruction. So even if you're going to improvise and do your own thing, you definitely absolutely need the machine gun. So just keep that in mind. Then, yeah, you want to get that jump that I just took. You want to save your nitrous until you're like all the way at the top of that ramp to ensure you you get those lightning spark plugs. Because otherwise you might turn up short later. So I would definitely recommend getting those. Now here, you know, spam enter, the usual sprint. Try to maneuver around these guys. They can be annoying, but hey, sometimes they don't spawn at all, so... But yeah, they can slow you down a little bit if you take... well, yeah, if you let them get in your way. But hey, just get over here, start the mission, get back to good old enter spamming. And then you can play this solo, the fan tribute, get the tower up, back to enter spamming, and then escape to get rid of that, buy your first dude. Make sure to buy that headbanger nice and fast. You know, you want to get your whole buy order started as soon as humanly possible, and you know, get this other fan tribute, the other fan geyser. It's really not necessary, but you know, it's part of the mission. Why not? Now you can see I'm alternating follow and stay commands to skip some dialogue. Right now it's not really relevant yet, but I just, you know, keep doing it. Now here, this is actually like the most relevant part. Here you definitely should do it, because there's like a bunch of lines from Leda and Ophelia and stuff. Then Eddie will say, you know, we need some Thunderhogs. That line can't be skipped, but then as soon as Manga starts talking, just do a command, and then you can buy the Thunderhog. Like, normally you would have to wait for Mangus to finish talking, but yeah, if you do a command, then you can get it out nice and quick. And again, after the Thunderhog comes out, spam some stuff, buy two more Razor Girls. Yeah, I play the play the battle cry for them. It's not super relevant because it will probably run out before like the rest starts here. But yeah, jump on the bike, let your units take care of the melee guys, and you take care of the ranged guys with a nice little face melter. Cancel the solo with escape, you know, so you don't get stuck watching a long animation. If your AI is being slow, you can help them out a little bit. And now, during this cutscene, you want to play Summon Deuce. And hit the follow command. Now, you want to go over here, because this is where it really gets interesting. This, what you're seeing right in front of me here, is Group 2. Not Group 1, Group 2. I want to kite them over to me by just, you know, shooting the big guy a little bit. Slowly back up and do a stay command here. I keep backing up like quite a bit so that those like razorettes, they're called groupies, right? You want them to actually like enter the playable area. Now same goes for these groupies, because you're probably gonna see in just a little bit. Yeah, there was like a pop-up that I'm exiting the mission area, because yeah, there's like, yeah, I'm nearing, you know, the end of the mission, and if you drive over that barrier, the mission will just end like hard. So, okay, what I'm killing right now, right here, these four groupies and one bouncer, that's group one. make sure that group 1 dies before group 2. You see? My AI is fighting group 2 and I took care of group 1. Now I took 1 down and 2 right after that. Get rid of Lion White here. Okay, and now you can chill for a little bit. Because group 3 is going to take a while. So what you want to do, get your AI over towards this area. I have this like little bush next to the water where I always go with them. Like, it's a nice reference for me personally. And just keep spamming the attack command until all the other markers go away. You know, it just needs to be one big central marker that they're all going to go to. Oop. Nice driving, buddy. I just do this because, yeah, like, you know, you're just chilling. You just need to wait for group 3 to actually enter the whole mission. Okay, see, what I got here is actually kind of unfortunate because they can enter the map from, like, slightly to the right of here, and they will cross, like, the mission bounds faster. So what I get here is a bit unfortunate, but it's still fine. Wait for them all to enter the mission bounds and then play a face melter nice and centered within that whole group so you can kill every single one of them with a single face melter. Then go and help your dudes out. Just really make use of that Disgorger that you got from the store. That was that secondary upgrade. It's completely free because it was originally a DLC weapon, but for the Steam release, it's all included in the game, so that's pretty nice. And they're extremely overpowered, so we love them, we speedrunners. Yep, okay, that's that group done with. What I'm gonna do now, get everyone to follow me, grabbing my car. Hey, I did that little animation skip, nice. Where I just, like, warp into my car. It's as far as I know, it's random, so, like, don't think I'm a god at this game or anything. Okay, just get them to follow, just steer them nice and close to the stage. Because you want them to back up nice and far. I'm gonna play Battle Cry. It's probably gonna run out, like, before it ever gets used, but doesn't matter. Why not, right? Alright. Now, I'm gonna go forward, have them follow me, but, like, I wanna keep them back as much as possible so that all these guys aggro me right now, so I can get as many kills as I possibly can out of my phase melter. Just hurt them a little bit, get back in your car, maybe give an attack command as well to make sure these guys die nice and fast. And there you go, Battleful Blade Henge, done with. That's a pretty good time if I do say so myself.
Oh, enough! I've never liked
skip, 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 go talk to Mangus, and now, don't touch anything.
Ready to go?
Don't touch anything.
Just a few more hours.
There, pop up.
Got 20 seconds. It's
yes,
time to go.
Those things are back. So yeah, wait for the pop-up to show, press escape, and then press enter to, like, you know, accept slash confirm starting the mission. If you spam too much, if you do things too quickly, you might get it in a way that the pop-up, you know, where you say, like, start the mission now or later, where that's green, and the secondary mission pop-up, where they line up, so that when you press escape to dismiss the secondary mission pop-up, you also dismiss starting the mission. If you do that, you're gonna be sad. I certainly am whenever that happens. Okay, so you could see here I was, you know, like, spawn-killing all the dudes, and I'm getting that jump for the lightning spark plugs, and now I'm driving absolutely awfully. I expect you to be better than me. How many of these guys are there? And we just get back to killing these dudes, you know, because my driving was awful. I got here late, otherwise I would just be spawn killing them again. But and we can just if they get too far away from me, I can just switch to the machine gun, and we can take care of them that way. So we've already done one jump a bit earlier. Like, if you just stick straight to that whole ramp where I was on, if you just, like, stick straight to the middle, like, there's even a line you can directly look at, you're perfectly fine. Here, once again, just stick nicely to the middle. Boom, get your fire tributes. Now I've got this ramp as well, but here I should say that, like, for most, you know, like, buying lists and stuff, you do not need to get every single one of these jumps. Like, clearly for that last one, I had to, like, do a complete 180, and if you're far behind the bus, like, I probably was, I can't say for certain, but, like, I was pretty far behind the bus, and I probably slowed myself down. I probably lost time there. But I'm just here to show you every single jump that you can take on this mission. But you kind of need to see for yourself how many you actually need. I think on this mission you could skip two of those jumps. That is the one that I told you about, the one where I had to do a whole 180, and the one that lands me like really close to the Metal Queen's lair. Like, those are both kind of off route, and they're kind of just like extra. So you should be able to skip both of those, and just as long as you don't miss any other jumps or forget about any other stuff that earns you fire tributes, then you should be totally fine for the next buy round. And then just get back to killing fools. Just spray all the blood on them so they explode. And they can't harass Mangus and you anymore. Now there's gonna be two guys like in front of the bus here, so I just hold down the machine gun and aim vaguely in their direction. It's extremely difficult to fail this mission, I have to say. Now I'm probably gonna do this. Yeah, I'm probably gonna jump out and do this. Again, that's just like, some fire tributes that you could get yourself, but currently I'm kind of under the impression that jumping out of your car actually slows Mangus down quite a bit, so I don't do that anymore. But it's just take it as a backup suggestion. If you really, really need the fire tributes, then there you can get five more. Okay. So, you just start the next mission, spam enter through all the cutscenes, and now press F as soon as you possibly can so you can start flying. And now there's a nice little space where you can breathe. Because there's just a bunch of dialogue. We don't need to do anything right now.
Now then, first thing we have to do is drive off those leeches.
Ooh, that's our cue. Okay. Aim at that far away guy and spam your scroll wheel or whatever button you might have bound to sending the beacon. Press 3 to guide them to that beacon, and then get ready on this one. So, fly nice and low, press F and an E, because you want to interact with the tab slab before the cutscene comes in. Then you can dismiss the book after the cutscene. You can dismiss two cutscenes at once. Uh-huh. Now, you heard a little drum, a little ding-ding-ding there. That was me buying units, but you can't see the unit menu anymore because we glitched that with the whole tab slab stuff. So you just want to, buy anything that's like to your top right, which is, either Hatbangers or Razor Girls. Either are fine. Now wait for the last parachute to pop, and then you can play your face melter, and all four should die just fine. If there's just one left, you can pick them off, it's fine. Get ready to play the battle cry, wait for your dudes to get a bit closer to you. There you go. Now, make sure none of them get stuck on this, like, Iron Cross platform thing. Because you want all three of them doing damage to this gate. Like, if you're missing even one of them, like Lita or Ophelia, even if you're, here doing the attacks with Lars, missing one dude will actually make a difference, so... If one gets stuck, you can kind of like push him off, and they'll just continue onto the gate. And if you do end up like having to do that, that shouldn't really lose you any time, but definitely do it, because you want everyone there with you. And that's your fist shall fall. Just skip all the RTS BS. Just go straight to the gate. Now that you're done, spawn your deuce, and we can get moving on to Pilgrimage of Screams. You can see, most of this stuff, after you've finished Battle for Bladehenge anyway, things get pretty straightforward. This is a pretty chill part of the route, I would say. I mean, there's still a bunch of things that you have to do on Fist Shall Fall, but I feel like it's pretty straightforward. Speaking of straightforward, just drive straight forward through the Razor Boar area. Go here, jump out of your car, go say hi to Ophelia, start the next mission.
What are those guys doing here?
Now, enter, the usual, and do an attack command. So all your dudes start moving forward, jump on the bike, and then as you pass them, you can do a follow command, and start setting up a beacon forward. There's cutscene. And get back on the bike. So they're either following you or going to that beacon. Either are fine. Like, beacon is preferred. Okay, set up another beacon. But don't tell them to go to that yet. Like, now you can. Because you wanna make sure they stay behind just a little bit. Because all those headbangers, you know, you want them to all, like, crowd around you for that face melter. You don't want them to aggro on your AI instead of you. So, okay, everything's going very smoothly. Everyone's moving on to that beacon over there. Do another follow. Now I'm going to set up a new beacon all the way at the end, all the way at the other side of that. There we go, nice. Wait, there he is. Then I do 343, like, I just spam some commands a little bit, again, to skip dialogue, but the relevant command I want to give them is, you know, go to the beacon, 3. Now, if you skip the dialogue correctly, then those 3 bouncers will just walk themselves into the lava. And the game checks. Once those 3 bouncers are dead, then the lava will, you know, like, go still and dark and cold and stuff, so you can walk over it. So that's a very nice little trick to kind of skip all the combat in this area. Here, I push the roadies up a little bit. Because the roadies are the ones that actually, like, need to enter this area trigger for the cutscene. Jump on a roadie, do one attack, have him follow you, like, do a beacon. That's stuff that I do, but it really doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is that you at least do that attack once to scare the birds off a little bit. And then you just walk to the end of the level. What your AI does really doesn't matter, because they are all slower than you no matter what you do, so you can just keep on moving here. Just walk all the way to the end of the level. These guys won't harass you too much, because they are too slow. And the gulls, they might hurt your ears a little bit, or irritate your ears a little bit, but again, totally fine. And there we go. Mission's over. Spam enter, spam enter, spam enter. Get rid of all those pesky cutscenes. Spam enter, spam enter, spam enter, and run, run. Do not spawn your douche yet, because... secondary mission pop up. Now, okay, you could spawn your car earlier than that, but, you know, I'm dumb. You know, the whole classic, do as I do, not as I do as I say, not as I do. Ugh, clearly. Don't do as I say either. Why are you watching this? No. I have some good advice, okay? Just not all the time. Again, you just want to drive back to that motor forge that you opened a while ago, and hopefully not run into any Tollusks on the way, which I almost did, because they're very annoying. Now, you want to enter here, and again, I'm just going to tell you the kind of the basic shopping list that's very good, but if you're experienced, then you can deviate from it. But as a starting runner, definitely just stick to the list. Buy your nitrous, nothing else. You buy Eye of Sorrow, nothing else. Go up to Guitar, Shredders, that's up one from the start, and buy the Fire Cord. It all went by very quickly, so okay, don't be ashamed to give it a second watch over. Now, for this, when you're exiting, you can actually spam this exit. There you go, with Enter. If you'll remember, the first time I exited, like, there was a bit of a longer, like, exiting cutscene. But, yeah. The next time you exit the motor forge, you can skip that. So just, like, spam enter as you exit, hold W, and then you can nitrous right out of it. There you go, put your beacon on that one, and there's some more dialogue, but we cannot skip, sadly.
How'd you do that?
I'm not exactly sure.
3, get moving, and play your battle cry. You know, wait for the whole wave to appear, and then dismiss it with escape. And there you go, face melter. Again, you wait for the explosion, and then you press this solo canceling. It's a lovely little trick. It's small time saves, but you do it all over the run, so they can really add up.
Damn.
Well, maybe we can sneak past
no.
together.
Hmm. Do I do it here? Okay. Walk to that whole bone pile. Oh, yeah. Exit earlier than I do here. Because the guy will not shoot you, but you can still, you know, you can line up with these roadies a little earlier than I did.
Like it's controlling all the wall-mounted
go, spam enter to get through this. Now, attack, then jump off. So you can get over the wall nice and quickly and put your beacon there. Press E, press 3. Press 3 again. Definitely press 3 a second time there. Then hold E to select only the roadies and send them over to the tower, because all your other units have to stay behind to not get killed by the tower. If they get killed by the tower, then the mission fails and will be very sad. And why I told you to face melter here, tell everyone to go forward. Do a face melter. You can wait like a little bit to make sure that the bouncer and the battle nun both get in your range. And then, you know, just knock this guy towards your units. Okay, now spam these commands. Spam some commands. The ones that work best for me, I think, are follow and go to beacon. So that's 3 and 4. So there's some more dialogue there that you can skip. And then you can get the deuce down. And get the starting sanctuary of sin. This is all going very smoothly, isn't it? And hop. Hello, Mangus.
What hold up? I was waiting for you.
Dude, you're enter, supposed enter, to set up the stage enter, an hour enter, ago. Enter. There we are. Then we can put our beacon nice and far ahead and press 3 a bunch of times to make him go there. Buy some units, put your flag down. Come on, put your flag down. Put your flag. There you go. There you go, bud. See, I'm super slow. I'm wicked slow. Now here, okay, I stand a little bit too far forward, but it's like the second tile up here, and it's kind of like 3/4 ahead. If you stand properly and you don't get shot by the tower like I do, because I'm terrible at this game, then you can just keep on shocking Lion White from far away. The tower won't shoot you, and Lion White like won't be able to do anything, and he will literally just go if you like just pretty much shock your guitar. No, shock him with your guitar until he like almost dies. And then he will go away, and you won't see him again for the rest of the mission. Unless you watch the cutscene, and then something fun might happen. And then, as soon as Lion White goes away, grab Lars, just bring him up here. Make sure that you stay out of the radius of that tower, so he doesn't shoot Lars off your shoulders. And then you can just destroy this gate. Pyow, 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 just keep on spamming left mouse button until the gate falls over and you can finish the mission. And that's all for this chapter. That was pretty straightforward.